Good morning and welcome to the Eucharistic celebration.
Good morning, Father.
It's a beautiful morning. We are here together. The word together means we are all children of God. So being together means loving together. We are experiencing the love of God in this celebration. Let us pray some time together in this celebration and pray in a special way for all the sick and shut-ins of our parish. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge all sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of hearts, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of God the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us and make those hastening to attain your promises highest to the treasures of heaven. Through Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Let us now sing the praises of famous men, our ancestors in their generations. Some of them have left behind a name so that others declare their praise, but of others there is no memory. They have perished as though they had never existed. They have become as though they had never been born. They and their children after them. But these also were godly men, whose righteous deeds have not been forgotten. Their wealth will remain with their descendants, and their inheritance with their children's children. Their descendants stand by the covenants, their children also for their sake. Their offspring will continue forever, and their glory will never be blotted out. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in its maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their king.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Let them praise his name with dancing, making melody to him with tambourine and lyre. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people. He adorns the humble with victory.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy on their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is glory for all his faithful ones.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
To go and bear fruit that will last,
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After his triumphant entry into Jerusalem, Jesus went into the temple, and when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. One day, when Jesus and the disciples came from Bethany, he was hungry. Seeing in the distance a fig tree in leaf, he went to see whether he would find anything on it. When he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for it was not the season for figs. He said to it, "May no one ever eat food from you again." And his disciples heard it. Then they came to Jerusalem, and he entered the temple and began to drive out those who were selling and those who were buying in the temple. And he overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who sold doves, and he would not allow anyone to carry anything through the temple. He was teaching and saying, "Is it not written, 'My house shall be called a house of prayer for all the nations,' but you have made it a den of robbers?" And when the chief priests and the scribes heard it, they kept looking for a way to kill him, for they were afraid of him, because the whole crowd was spellbound by his teaching. And when evening came, Jesus and his disciples went out of the city. In the morning, as they passed by, they saw the fig tree withered away to its root. Then Peter remembered and said to him, "Rabbi, look, the fig tree that you cursed has withered." Jesus answered them, "Have faith in God. Truly I tell you, if you say to this mountain, 'Be taken up and thrown into the sea,' and if you do not doubt in your heart, but believe that what you say will come to pass, it will be done for you. So I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it, and it will be yours. Whenever you stand praying, forgive if you have anything against anyone, so that your Father in heaven may also forgive you your trespasses." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This Gospel passage is a long passage with a lot of content to reflect on. We have seen two stories, one about fig tree and also what Jesus said about against the temple. There is something common in these two stories. What is that? What did Jesus expect from the fig tree and expect from the people of Israel? Bear fruit. In both of the stories, we see that God always expects fruits from us. What kind of fruit? And we have seen in the last days when we listened to the Gospel passage as well as the scripture passages, we have to bear fruit, the fruits of the Spirit, love, peace, kindness, gentleness. All these are the fruits of the power of the Spirit. As Christians, we have to bear fruit, these fruits. So, when we come to the last, so today, in place of these people of Israel, we have the church, the Holy Church. Church is a community, it's a loving community, must be a loving community. As a loving community, it must be a forgiving community. That's why at the end of today's gospel passage, we listen to Jesus saying, forgive. Are we ready to forgive? So a forgiving community always will be a loving community. Let us forgive each other and let us forgive our trespasses as God forgive our trespasses in our daily life. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the wine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and the words may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid up open before us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need for our praise, yet our thanksgivings is itself your gift. Since our praises are nothing to your greatness, but profit us for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim,
Holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and full of God for his name. Holy name for these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis and our Bishop Christian and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased me throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teachings, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with his spirit.
Let's all pray to God. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you.
prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be coerced in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
As is ended, go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
As usual, we have on Fridays, we have 15 minutes of adoration. I welcome you all, be present, and be with Jesus, my wife. Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of the kingdom where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed be God, blessed be His holy name, blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man, blessed be the name of Jesus, blessed be His most sacred heart, blessed be His most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit of Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God.